All right, this is round three. Oh, this hand is great, especially because we have Servant and Cloudblazer. We also have a turn one play and a turn two play and a turn three play. Ideally, we'll draw lands for those. Yeah, this hand is pretty solid. And we get four energy. Make that turtle big. So, ideally we have to hit land here, because then we can play Bristling Hydra on turn 3, Cloudblazer on turn 4, and that's basically a constructed deck. Oh, no! Let's go counter. Attack with this guy. Alright. Well, we did miss a land drop, unfortunately. Ideally, we won't miss any more. Alright, no bounce. No bounce. Oh, it's super cruel. We're just going to pass here. Dealing one is not worth trading with this guy. Yeah, we're just going to pass. Now, if we draw a land, we're in good shape because we can play Wild Wanderer, which is basically like getting a permanent land. Gonti. That's real sad. That guy's very good. I probably would have saved Aviary Mechanic just to block, just to rebuy Gonti, which is super sweet. Come on, land. Yes. Yes. It's just Bristling Hydra here, right? Just trades with this guy, though. That's pretty brutal. Yeah, I'm the Wanderer of the Wild Wanderer. Yeah, we'll just play this guy. Get a Plains. So we don't have to rely on the other lands. Or the Servant, rather. So any land lets us play Cloudblazer. And we can also cast everything now. We can also malfunction this Gonti, so hopefully they didn't get anything good. Oh, 100% trade with Wild Wanderer here. Let your fortuitous find. And if you have a trick, that's also fine. Like, this is just a very disposable creature for us. If you want an impeccable timing or built to last, those are all fine. Yep, paying costs. Sure, you got it. Good deal. And now I feel better about putting a malfunction on that guy. Yeah, I knew it was an arrow responder. Wow, why did I know that? That's so weird. I was like, they're gonna play arrow responder. And they did. And they did. They played the arrow responder. What's the play here? Cloudblazer doesn't do much. We don't need plays here. Tiger could be very good. Then they just attack with both of these guys, right? Or do we just malfunction? Actually, we can block with High Spire Artisan, right? So that's not a thing we care about. Yeah, this guy's fine. I like Tiger here because it costs more mana. So we have 6 mana right now. So if we play Hydra and draw like something else, we can actually cast it, which is nice. Interesting, they don't want to trade with their Gonti. Do another... Wow, alright, you got it. Just mono tricks over here, I guess. Aspire Artisan was not meant to block these days. Yep, you got it. Good old 2-2. Aether Works Marvel. We're going to malfunction this guy. And we'll just use the energy. Sure.
we have 6 mana. If we doesn't matter what we draw, we need 2 lands to play 2 things. So, yep, take it. They have 3 cards and this card. Might have to play a little slower of a game, I guess. Are you gonna play my card? Wow. That's brutal. I guess we can just block it, right? Alright, so at least we know what it is now. And if we draw the... I think we have any other trade winds in the deck. God, that arrow responder is so hard to deal with. We can't attack into it. We still have to take damage from it. Jeez. They're just slowly gaining. They're gaining on us. God, they still have 4 cards in hand. Wow. Bristling Hydra was like the best thing they could have hit there, I think. The next time we can go Aetherworks Marvel and Bristling Hydra, so. We'll just go to 14. Stop playing things. Oh boy. Actually, maybe we play our own Hydra here. 2 activations, which make it a 5. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 mana. So we can actually play both of these, but I don't know if that's good. Feels reasonable. I mean, we miss 1 trigger from this if we don't. I think it's actually Hydra. And Sage. Yeah, it seems better. Is this a bug? How do you have 2? Well, let me tell you. So now the Dund operative has Death Touch, which is a little frustrating. But manageable. Frustrating, but manageable. Like, I actually don't want to kill their Bristling Hydra until we actually get Aetherworks Marvel online, because then we get a free energy, but it might just be too greedy to do that. I can't trade a Riparian Tiger. I'm just going to go to 8 here, because I think it's fine. You know, this is a lot of dudes. Do we have -2/-2 on our sideboard? Because that would kill this guy. Well, not this guy, I guess. Not anymore, anyway. Okay, let's see what that does. Looks like nothing. Play a land. Okay. So, it's real hard to get past Dund Operative and Arrow Responder here, so. This Arrow Responder's got to go. They only have 3 energy. Let's block with a Tiger. Get an energy. Energy! Man, Error Responder, why you gotta be like this? Why you keep playing things? Wow. You just blink Gonti. Oh, brutal. Let's see what we can hit here. Dynavolt Tower. That doesn't do much. Another Tiger. Also not great. I feel like we just put Tiger into play and then concede, because this is a board state we can't really beat, unfortunately. And they get a free card. They get to look. They also have two Death Touch guys, which is just not something the green deck can overcome. Yeah, we're just going to scoop here, unfortunately. Let's see what they would have gotten. Getting 1, 2, 3, 4. Either trade ones would have been pretty brutal. They can bounce their Gonti a second time and then just bounce one of our things. We would have drawn an island followed by a Sage. Okay. Hazardous conditions could actually be good here. We already have Prophetic Prism and Servant and Wild Wanderer. So if we can add a black, could be reasonable. Actually, Takedown's probably fantastic here. I wonder if 6/6s are good. Shrewd Negotiation. Do we have enough things that we can get rid of? I think we established that we don't, right? We basically have the single High Spire Artisan and a Prophetic Prism that we actually want to give away. Yeah, I'm just smelling this. We'll see what happens. I will play first this time. I don't know if I did last time, too. This hand's rough because it's got 3/5 drops, a 4 drop. I'm going to mulligan this hand, I think. It's not much better, but it'll do. Got to put Bristly on the bottom. We just don't have the resources for it. I don't know if we're actually going to win this game. Well, we do need some lands and some things that are... Well, that is neither. That is neither a land nor a thing that does stuff for us. Dunned Operative. Yep. How do you know these things? I just know. Land? It's actually less problematic when we have a Prophetic Prism in play, which is nice. Error Responder. Dang it! The one time we won it, and you're gonna make a dude, so this is a 3/2. It seems fine. Old Terts McGirts. Pretty much a blank here. Well, I guess we can block the 2/2. And we only take 4, that's nice. What a relief! But still pretty far behind here. And if they have impeccable timing, it's just very bad for us, which they don't seem to. All right, well, that's nice. I guess they just don't care about our turtle that much. That's rude. Wow. All right. Remember when we were going to board in hazardous conditions? Me too. Hundred percent block Dunned Operative if they attack. Yeah, their deck is a little too aggressive for us, unfortunately. Oh, it's never any easier, is it? We take 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9 here. That's pretty good. We go to 4 on turn 4. That's nice. On turn 5, I guess. We've missed 2 land drops. Yeah, this isn't really a game, but... Yeah, there's, like, nothing we can draw here. Malfunction on, like, this guy. We block here. We take 6. Yep, that's... Sad that we gotta go out that way, but what are you gonna do? That is magic.